Hello guys, GT Racing here, and today we are going to take a quick look at the newly released Autodromo Enzo Edino Ferrari, or Imola. The lap that I'm going to show you is my entry for the special event number 82, where you are supposed to do a hot lap with the GT4 Audi, around Imola of course. The resulting lap time was a 155.996 and ended up placing me in 137th. So while a replay of said lap is playing in the background, I'm going to pause it from time to time and just quickly talk you through my lap. And afterwards we are going to switch in the cockpit cam and I will let the lap run through without any intermissions from my side. So for the actual first turn, there's not really much to say as it is just a casual left kink that can be taken full out. Next on, you'll want to focus on the right side of the track, and shortly after 200 meters brake marker, an orange box or whatever the heck it is appears there. And as soon as you, the driver, are at the same height as this box, horizontally speaking of course, you want to hit the brakes as hard as you can. When approaching the chicane, be sure to use the full track width, which means using all of the available curvings on the right side. Then you can already start to look forward and plan your entry into the chicane. There are two things that can either gain or lose you massive amounts of time. So first of all, you want to make sure to trail brake into the chicane until you hit the first curbs on the left side. And while doing so, it is crucial to never clip the yellow curb rings, as they are quite a bit higher than the usual green ones and will majorly unsettle your car. The same goes of course for the exit of the chicane. For turn 4, it is easily sufficient if you place your car towards the middle of the track, as at the exit of this corner the track actually goes quite wide again. Oh yeah, and be sure to never force your car into this corner, as you then could start to slide, which loses you a lot of time. Instead, turn in quite smoothly and abuse the broad curbings at the corner exit. For the next corner, you want to start braking at around 80 meters and absolutely make sure that you overslow your car, as the exit of this chicane is exponentially more important than the entry. For turn 7, you want to brake at or around 55 meters, which correlates to the end of the grey tire mark patch on the right side before the 50 meters board. Make sure to pick a late apex and ideally also try to avoid the inside curbs. Turn 8 requires you to brake hard at a 50 meters board and carry a lot of speed into the corner in order to maximize your exit. Then you can already start to shift your focus towards the left side of the track, as your braking point should be around 60-65 meters. Do not overslow your car here, but rather let it flow into the beginning of the double right-hander by clipping the first inside curb, go all the way to the left and exploit the track limits to the fullest, as this will simultaneously open up your entry to the next right-hander. Coincidentally, your next braking reference is again, as in the beginning, an orange box. As soon as this box exits your view, you want to slam your brakes and this time overslow your car and aim for the earliest throttle application possible. At the exit, you are free to use all available curbings, but however, be sure to not overdo it, because if you slide off at the left side of the curbs, you basically need to rejoin the track again, which makes the curbs then act as an artificial bump, which can cost you up to 1/10. For the last chicane, you want to start braking as soon as the curbings on the left side of the track start to emerge. Now, this might sound a bit counterintuitive, but in this chicane, you really want to abuse those high curbs. So try to line them up in a straight line and basically drive straight over them. And as soon as you're hitting the second yellow curb, you can already start to accelerate again, but not too rapidly, as your car doesn't have enough traction due to it probably still bouncing from the curbs. Even though there are only two corners left, there is literally no time to relax. The penultimate corner on this track probably features the most difficult braking zone in all of ACC's tracks. If you're confident in your abilities, it is possible to slow down your car enough when you start braking at the 100 meters board. However, I would not recommend this, because as soon as you lock up in the slightest, you will inevitably run wide and ruin your lap. I found it much more beneficial to brake at around 110 or 150 meters, but therefore nailing the braking zone 10 out of 10 times. Now, for the last corner, you don't actually need to brake, as it is sufficient to just let your car flow into the corner. Your turning point would be when the green curbings with the white triangles on them on the right side start to fade. However, if you think you've missed your turning point or are approaching the corner a bit too fast, you can simply tap your brakes once, which will allow for a better turn in, but you will sacrifice a bit of straight line speed on the ongoing straight. So yeah, that is the lap around Imola in a GT4 car in ACC. And as I said in the beginning, I will now let the whole lap run through in cockpit cam without any intermissions from my side. If you did enjoy this video or would like to see any adaptations for the next one, I'd be happy to receive your feedback in the comments, as long as it is constructive. And with that said, I wish you all a Merry Christmas and stay safe. Cheers.